We all know that in a billion years or so, the sun will start its transformation into a red giant. In other words, it will start getting bigger, and when it does that, the extrasolar energy that we receive on Earth will likely dry up all the oceans and destroy most of life on Earth. If humanity didn't move to another planet, our numbers will probably start to dwindle, and that will likely be the end. But don't worry, because we don't have to wait a billion years for death to happen. Consider the Doomsday Argument. First proposed by Brandon Carter, the Doomsday Argument is basically an argument that claims to predict the number of future members of the human species based on the total number of humans born so far. As of today, the argument says that the number of humans alive right now are probably at the halfway point on the entire human history timeline. For instance, suppose that 10 trillion humans will have ever lived, and we have given them all a number from 1 to 10 trillion. If we randomly picked a human today, chances are that he or she will not be among the first 10% of humans that have ever lived, and that his or her number will not be a number from 1 to 1 trillion. In other words, the person we picked will more likely have a number from 7 to 10 trillion instead. Applying Leslie's figure and Copernicus's principle, there's a 95% chance that the total number of humans that ever will live is around 1.2 trillion. Assuming that the world population stabilizes at 10 billion, with a life expectancy of 80 years, it can be estimated that the remaining 1,140 billion humans will be born in 9,120 years. Anyways, the main point is that 1.2 trillion humans is likely the maximum total number of humans that will ever exist. This is also saying that humanity will likely end in 10,000 years. And if you don't think the human race will ever go extinct, just look at the dinosaurs. The dinosaurs ruled the Earth for over 150 million years. Then they either died off or evolved into other species. Who's to say that a giant rock won't hit Earth and do the same to us? There are fish that live thousands of miles underneath the sea, where pressure reaches the most extreme. There are thermophiles that live in extremely hot conditions. And there are anaerobic organisms that do not require oxygen,